Let's get you started searching for listings in Bright. Go under the search menu from the mega menu on the top of the screen. Head to your first column on the left, and you'll find a property type for each one of the individual types within Bright. If you'd like to search by more than one property type, you can use multiple property types, the bottommost option. For our example, we're going to go ahead and do a residential sale search. When you come to this screen, you'll notice there are many fields appearing by default. All of these are optional. It's up to you what you choose to search by. We're going to cover several of the different types of search fields that you'll find on this screen. Let's start with county. You can just start typing the name of the county you're interested in, select from the drop-down, and repeat that process if there's more than one. Or you can click on the lookup icon to see what your options are. You could scroll through or start typing the name of the next county. Select it, click add, and say OK. If you change your mind, you can always click the X to remove an option. Throughout the screen, you'll notice that there are question mark icons. If you're not sure of the definition of a field or how to enter the information, if you click on the question mark, it'll open up a pop-up with our online support information. Now, you'll notice on many of the fields, there are radio buttons underneath, an or a not. That'll let you indicate to the system what you want to do or how you want the system to treat the options you've selected. Do you want the system to consider it an either or? You'll take either one, or do you not want them included? There's another quick tip for searching different ways in these fields as well. If, for instance, you would like to do a contained search or a wildcard search, you can put asterisks on either side of characters that you want the system to search for. In my example, I used north. If you would like to exclude a specific set of characters from your search, you can use an exclamation point at the beginning of those characters. Coming down the page, you'll notice there are also fields where you can select whatever options you're interested in. Status uses check marks. And for statuses, we can further narrow by dates or days. If you hover over the field, you'll notice it's giving you a little bit of instruction on how you can choose to search those. Using a hyphen for a range, using a plus to set a minimum, using a minus to set a maximum. You can also use the calendar icon if you'd like to choose your date range that way as well. Those same basic guidelines about searching by a range or setting a minimum or maximum will also work in any of the other date or numerical fields, like price for an example. Notice that price is already in thousands. There's a little check mark by your zeros in parentheses there that indicates that. You can always remove that check mark if you'd like to search by less than 1,000. Coming down the page, you'll also find scrollable fields like other rooms where you can take a look at all your options. If you'd like to choose more than one item from the list, hold down the control key as you make your selections if you're on a PC. If you're on a Mac, you'll want to use the command key instead. This field individually has or and not. It also has an and button, which would indicate to the system when selected that you want all of the options that are highlighted to be included on listings. Coming down the page, you also have some drop-down fields where you can make your desired selection or leave it set to blank and the system will treat it as not applicable. Looking at your screen, in the very bottom, you have some navigation buttons. You have a clear that will remove your criteria, a matches button that'll calculate how many listings are a match for the criteria you've entered, 5,000 is the max, a button to take you to the map and to the results. Map and results are also tabs that you'll find at the top of the screen, along with a recent searches dropdown where you can revisit any recent searches you've done, and a gear icon where you can set currently selected search criteria as your starting default. If you don't happen to find the field that you're interested in, there is a section at the bottom called Additional Fields where you can click on the Add link and see all of the available fields that can be entered about a listing. Select your option on the left, click the Add button, and go back to the screen. You'll find that new field that you've added at the bottom of the page, and it'll come back each time you come to this screen until you remove it. Click Map or Results in order to view listings that match your criteria.